DJ Spoon Breath. Yeah!
The red carpet is ready
for you. Yeah, sure. The red carpet is ready. No, it's fine. It's 1, 2, 3. Good morning, Aries! Welcome to the DJ Spoon Breakfast! Welcome, 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 welcome!
Oh my goodness, guys, she
making me feel so, like, comfortable.
She is stunning.
She's stunning, guys. She's beautiful. Muhle, muhle, muhle. Ungabona laba she advert bathi sandleni ungabhala ukoma. Yena esandisa ungabhala ubuhle.
Ubuhle.
Ungabhala
ni
ubuhle.
Beauty, 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 beauty. Smart money woman. Where does that come from? Where does that come from?
It basically came from a personal struggle that I went through. So I was 27, my marriage ended, and then I had a one-year-old child, and I basically had to, like, restart my life, and it was really expensive. And I realized that I wasn't saving and investing enough in proportion to my income. And then I started wondering, what about other women who don't even work in finance, don't, you know, have my background? Who's talking to them about financial empowerment? So I wrote my first article called A Chanel Bag versus a Stock Portfolio for a platform called Bella Niger. And it was a huge success, and it basically just went from there. And then I decided to write a book.
And as a mother, what role are you playing in parenting your child and teaching them about these types of issues?
As a mother, I'm raising my daughter to be very confident. Zakora, she's 6.
Congratulations, by the way. 6 years old.
She's 6 years
Mine
old.
Mine is only turning 4 next month. Oh, sorry, in October. Yeah.
Aww.
Oh, that's nice.
It's
6,
such a
that's
cute
nice.
Age as well.
Yeah.
I'm teaching her to be really confident, to, you know, speak up, to protect herself. But I think what really bothers me more than the random acts of, you know, violence are the situations of domestic violence, like when a woman is in a relationship and stays in it because she feels like she has no other choice, even if the man is hurting her. And I think a lot of that comes from not being financially empowered, because when women feel like they don't have other options, this man is looking after me and my kids, you know, I will lose my lifestyle, it forces them to stay in those situations. So what I'd like to do is teach women to be financially empowered so that they don't have to stay in those kind of situations.
You have an MSc in Economic Development from the University College of London and a BSc in Business Management from the Aston Business School, Birmingham.
Sure.
So
for
you, have, you know, she studied really well, and I feel like people can get lost in the jargon of financial literacy. How do we simplify it so that the young woman on the street, the young man on the street, the new employee can understand the importance of investment?
Okay, definitely, because I think that's what my book is all about, because The Smart Money Woman is, it's not a, when I wanted to write a personal finance book, I thought, do you know what, my target audience is millennials. I don't want to do the, this is how you save, this is how you, you know, invest. I thought it was important to create a story around it that women like me would be able to relate to. So The Smart Money Woman is a fictional book. It tells the story of 5 African girls and their personal finance struggles. So there's a lot of stuff in there about, you know, relationships, love, family, and its connection to money. And then it has smart money lessons at the end of each chapter and financial exercises that, like, the reader can, you know, do to get on the right track with their finances.
I've been to Nigeria a couple of times, and I've seen that you guys are an entrepreneurial nation,
yeah, we are.
Which is highly inspiring. Mm-hmm. And you find a Nigerian in any part of the world, and which is even more inspiring. The music industry right now, all over the world, the eyes are on Africa. Why? You guys are big ambassadors for the continent when it comes to music. You guys are go-getters. and when I say you come from a cash economy, the inspiration behind you wanting to teach people about finances,
So you're asking,
what does that come from?
I think that Africa, we're very resource rich, not even just Nigeria, like, we're very resource rich, but a large proportion of us are still poor because we've not learned how to keep it or grow it. So the focus is always on how do we make money, how do we make money, how do we make money. But no one has really taught us that what wealth really means is how you're able to convert the income that you have into assets that can protect you in the future. We've not learned that as a country, you know, Nigeria, we've not learned that as a continent, and we've not learned that
as black people. Yeah.
It's all about, I have 100 million rand in my account, how can I spend 100 million rand, as opposed to how can I convert some of that stuff into assets that can pay me and protect me, you know, in the future.